Yes, spiders can fly. Take a look at this little guy. In this nightmare fuel of a video, the spider in question is using a technique called ballooning to achieve flight. Let me get out of the way so you can see. Ballooning, sometimes called kiting, is a process by which spiders and some other small invertebrates move through the air by releasing one or more gossamer threads to catch the wind, causing them to become airborne, seemingly at the mercy of air currents. Gossamer threads are fine, filmy substances spun by small spiders. This is primarily used by spiderlings to disperse. However, larger individuals have been observed doing so as well. The spider climbs to a high point and takes a stance with its abdomen to the sky, releasing fine silk threads from its spinneret until it becomes aloft. You know, like a balloon or a kite. Except, those things are fun, and this is terrifying. Spider flights have ranged from a few meters to hundreds of kilometers. So just stay out of the wind, and you'll be safe from an airborne arachnid attack, right? A new study suggests that might not be the case. In fact, floating on the breeze isn't even these spiders' greatest trick, because these creepy crawlies can fly without the wind. Ugh, that makes me feel so uncomfortable. So, how can something fly without wings or wind? By harnessing the power of Earth's magnetic field to propel themselves through the air. Duh. Doctors Erica L. Morley and Daniel Robert of the University of Bristol found that when spiders are placed in a windless chamber with no breeze, but a small electric field, they were still able to fly. On, off. On, off. Pretty cool, right? Also, it is so irresponsible to tease a spider that can float. We don't want them to turn on us. Off. So how does it work? Let's break it down. Ballooning uses multiple strands of silk in a fan-like shape to catch the wind and float like a dandelion. Here, instead of tangling and meandering in light air currents, each silk strand is kept separate, most likely to facilitate a repelling electrostatic force. This spider is almost certainly using electricity to levitate. A team of researchers found that sensory hairs on spiders' bodies moved whenever an electric field was turned on. These hairs, known as trichobothria, stand up, much like human hairs do from static electricity, and signaled that a spider's takeoff was imminent. For a better understanding of the spider's behavior under electric fields, the scientists looked to bumblebees, whose mechanosensory hairs are also sensitive to electric fields. These early studies with electrostatic forces suggest that a spider's trichobothria is sensitive to electric fields and might be what incites its liftoff and airborne behavior. If Morley and Robert's proposal that spiders can detect electric fields is proven, the spooky arachnids will be the second arthropod species after bees known to use electric fields at levels found under natural atmospheric conditions. And hey, I don't mind if spiders are suddenly scarier, because I've got a secret weapon. Off. I'm Peter Hess, I'm a senior science writer at Inverse, and I know things, and I know you want to hit subscribe, I know you want to hit that bell and get notifications when we've got cool new science and tech videos out. Peace.